majority of the youth, especially girls, produced during COVID. And these are single mothers. They could not go back to schools. And now they are being supported with skills so that they can support their children and support themselves.
We are happy about this program. I ran away from my country, Congo, due to insurgency, and we are here in the settlement with children who are not in school. Personally, I have two children with one disabled. They are all not in school. I thank God for NRC who brought the skilling program. I am now at St. Bruno offering a course in Salon, and I hope to start earning a living soon. We yearn for more support because there are many who need some help. Recognizing the urgency and importance of supporting vulnerable young people, the Norwegian Refugee Council, in partnership with the Conrad Hilton Foundation, has embarked on a life-changing initiative. Dixon Odu, NRC's Media and Communications Coordinator, says the project is driven by the belief that unlocking the potential at-risk youth by providing them with the necessary tools and resources is essential for their personal development and the prosperity of the community. The initiative being implemented at St. Bruno Training Institute offers vulnerable youth with skills in the areas such as agriculture, carpentry, shoemaking, knitting and tailoring, bricklaying, catering and hairdressing.
NRC's approach to youth at risk goes beyond skilling them. We are providing them with seed capital for their businesses and also revamping various businesses in the community that might have stalled for one reason or the other. So by addressing these multiple aspects of economic empowerment, we are creating a society that is more resilient, that is more sustainable, and that is more inclusive for this youth, so that they can be able to really get a bit of income for themselves and become productive citizens of tomorrow.
Ngosole Ndasolekwa, a refugee from Congo and a beneficiary of the first intake of the initiative, hailed NRC for stepping up efforts to empower vulnerable young Ugandans. He reported that the skills he acquired in carpentry enabled him to start a workshop in Naki Valley, where he is earning close to 60,000 shillings per day.
I joined the program also of technical school through the NRC organization. I was also among the people who were selected to join the technical desk to learn the skills. After joining it, I learned about carpentry and the joinery.
In addition to vocational training under the initiative, NRC offers startup capital to support the youth in starting or expanding their businesses. Sister Dina Charimpa noted that financial assistance has played a crucial role in empowering aspiring entrepreneurs, enabling them to overcome financial obstacles that often hinder their progress.
We don't select, but we use local leaders to select the most vulnerable youth in their communities, and then they forward them to NRC, then NRC brings them here. And this procedure is good because it reaches down to the village, and these local leaders know their people more than we do.
The challenges of the youth are really great. So one of the ways that we can really address this is through skills development. And skills development is really the way forward for youth that have been out of school or youth that have really fallen through some challenges such as early pregnancies. So it's our call as NRC for us to come together across the divide, government, civil society, donors.
Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.